So I will now demonstrate the construction of the time displacement curve of cycloidal motion. We will have this as our total displacement, with this as our time. The division of the total time can be 8, or it can be any number, any number of divisions. For our purpose, we will be using 8 divisions of the time. So what we have to do here is that we will have to connect this line at this point and extend this here. And at any point here, any location here, we have to make this circle. So this circle has a diameter of h over pi. And now we can now divide the circle into 8. So that will be 8 divisions. And with here as a starting point, this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now, to make the construction of the curve, we'll start with 0, project it to the center, and then project it to that point here. From 1, we'll have to project it to the vertical line, and then project it again to here. So that is to be parallel. And from 2, we'll have to project it here. Again, these three are parallel lines. From 3, again, that will have to be here. That will be followed by 4, which will be the point here. For 5, that will be another parallel line. And 6, will be another parallel line. And 7, and 8. So this is our curve for cycloidal motion. Again, this height has to be divided by pi to be able to determine the diameter of this circle here, which we are going to use in the construction of our target. And again, the number of divisions of this will be at your convenience. It can be 8, it can be 6, it can be 10 or 9 or 7. But for our example here, we use 8 divisions.